Hello, these are traditionally known as condensation trails or contrails, and we have all seen them a thousand times. Since the 1990s though, it is increasingly thought that some of these are actually chemicals being sprayed into the atmosphere, so now they are being called chemtrails. This so-called conspiracy theory has been discussed endlessly on social media, but suspiciously not so much in mainstream media. In this video I'm going to reveal a new photo that has never been seen before, and I believe will truly blow your mind. As with my previous videos about vaccines and the flat earth, I have made a physical puzzle that relates to the subject which I will solve for you. In fact, I will reveal the new photo by solving the puzzle, so let's make a start. It's based on the classic 15 puzzle, and the new photo is currently scrambled. The types of chemicals being sprayed is uncertain. Some think they are not directly harmful to people, but are used to change the weather or reduce global warming by partially blocking out the sun. Some believe they relate to psychological manipulation and controlling us. Others think they are killing us in order to reduce world population. Evidence comes from leaked photos like these showing the chemical containers inside the planes. People also track planes in their schedules and determine that no aircraft should be in a specific area where the trails are seen. They also say that real condensation trails would not stay around for so long. Okay, so the puzzle is nearly solved. You may have worked out by now that this amazing image has chemtrails that look like letters of the alphabet. I believe the government has deliberately put a hidden message into the sky aimed at people who know that chemtrails are real. The message isn't that clear, so I will let all of you truthers out there make your own minds about what it says. Well, that was the hardest 2 minutes of my life, though a lot of fun. I obviously do not believe in chemtrails, and there's never been a shred of evidence to support them or any other lunatic conspiracy theory. Images like these show flight test planes and water-filled tanks to simulate passengers. If our democratically elected governments really wanted to get chemicals inside people, they would simply put them in the water supply or the drinks that you buy. They would not haphazardly spray them from planes thousands of feet in the air. Right, back to normality. This is the puzzle I used. It's a Klotsky puzzle, which of course is just a 15 puzzle. I chose this one because it's nice and big. So I'm just gonna mix this up and then solve it as you would normally. Now I actually had one of these before I got into twisty puzzles, well before the Rubik's Cube was even invented. I kind of liked puzzles back then, but you know, not massively so. So I only like solved it maybe 4 or 5 times. So my solving is going to be pretty dreadful and slow, but I'll get there in the end. Right, so I think that's mixed, so let's go for a solve. I was going to finish the video there, but I suddenly realised I hadn't actually solved the chemtrail puzzle, because it was fake, the one I did earlier. I just had to do it in a certain way to make it kind of look right. So if I don't solve it, then I'm basically a liar. So I'd better solve it, I guess. I'm not really looking forward to doing it properly because I think it's going to be pretty difficult. I mean, the part with the letters is going to be fairly straightforward, but the bottom section is, well, it's not going to be very easy. Right, I think that's pretty much mixed. So I'm going to start with this section with the letters, because I think that's going to be the easiest part of it. So that's the top row done, or for you, the bottom row. Right, so that's the next row done. Now this is where it gets tricky. Pretty sure those two pieces go there, but that doesn't really help me at this time. I think it's that piece goes there and that piece goes where it is now. So I need to get that one and that one together. Well, we've got that one in. I kind of lost the track a little bit there of what I was doing. I think it'd be nice to get that one, which I think is that piece. Right, so I got that as well. So it's just a case of these six pieces. And again, it's really not clear. I think that goes there. So much more difficult than with the numbers. I can kind of see where some of the pieces go, but it's. So those pieces go like that. What was that piece has to go over there? So that piece is that one has to go there. Yeah, that's it. So it's kind of like, it's a little bit of luck. I was kind of like putting pieces where I kind of thought they roughly had to go, and eventually it just sort of comes up. If you are interested in getting an original version of this puzzle, I've put a link in my description. They are available in several different sizes.